It's time for the NBA. Live on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan with Steve Kerr and Clark Kellogg alongside. And our sideline report tonight is Doris Burke. And now a quick check of our starting lineups for both teams. First for Chicago, and Strong is out there with Jordan. We've got Purdue, a very solid big man who'll be making every effort to control the glass and make some big plays on the rim. Then it's Pippen, and it's Kukoc, and at the power forward position. And for Indiana, now here's Jackson. Number 45, Kukoc with the defensive effort.
Well, guys, for the Pacers, it's been a slow and long climb from the malice at the Palace back in 04. But now with a terrific young team fresh off a strong showing in the Eastern Conference Finals, we can finally say the Pacers are back and they're going to be around for a while contending for a championship.
Tipped away. The tie for the ball. Two on none. No one back to stop this. Pull-up jumper. Misses off the left eye.
Defensive foul. Tony Kukoc.
Jackson with it, and for the Pacers, ever since their unfortunate night in Detroit, the attendance in Indiana has sank. They've been at the bottom half percentage-wise, Steve, for the last 9 years.
Well, it's time for the fans to come back, Kevin. You know, this is an elite team. They've got really high character, good guys. You know, ticket prices are about 60% less than the league norm. One of the best arenas in the NBA, and hey, it's Indiana. I mean, this is a basketball state.
Six to shoot. Jordan kicks to Kukoc. No good. And Indiana will go the other way with it. Doris Burke had a chance to catch up with head coach Tom Thibodeau.
Kevin, interestingly, he said he would only watch one half of the court this game and know how it would turn out, saying, if we can get our stops on defense, then we will win. Simple as that. I'm expecting some tough defense coming from that side in this one, guys.
Thanks for the report, Doris. Steve, Clark, your thoughts on their defensive focus here?
Well, it's the right strategy, Kevin, because you have to play to your strengths as a team. You can't get away from who you are.
And that's right, Steve. Their strength is certainly what they do defensively. They can rattle folks.
Armstrong against Jackson. Armstrong kicks to Jordan.
Hit me, I'm open.
Outside Pippen. Back to Jordan. Some nice ball movement by the Bulls. Kukoc dishes to Jordan. The pass to Kukoc. Six on the shot clock. To the paint. And Jackson gets it to go.
Jackson!
And then tie this game up.
You know, size-wise, this is not a great one-on-one matchup for him, but he got that shot to go.
But you wouldn't know it by how he finished. That's a nice hoop there.
Now, here's Pippen. Outside Jordan, he feeds it to Armstrong. And the Bulls with another miss.
I thought you'd make that one. That's his range and defense nowhere to be seen.
Here's Jackson. Number 45. That's good.
It's a great play on the boards for him. And, you know, that's the standard that he sets. It seems like all those second chance points, I mean, they're there for him game in, game out.
Now here's Jordan. And so he ends up kicked to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot two.
Well, what I like about him, Kevin, is his ability to shake a defender loose off the dribble and find a high-quality shot for himself. He is a very slippery player.
And he's very much a student of the game in terms of getting to know the tendencies of whichever player he's guarding on any given night and then gearing his defensive game plan to what he needs to do to stop him.
Here's Mitchell. Number three. Hands it from downtown.
Looked like there was a little confusion there as to who was supposed to be guarding him.
52 seconds left in the first quarter. Armstrong with it. Pippen kicks to Jordan. With the fadeaway. The shot's good on the assist by Pippen.
Great looking bounce pass to set up that play.
Indiana's gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. Number three. No good on the triple. Chicago trailing here. 24 seconds left in the first. Armstrong kicks to Pippen. Pass to Jordan.
Scott's there. Lock and six. Jordan dishes to Pippen. Backing down is Jordan. Davis brings it down.
Major defensive lapse right there. And he's not a player you can leave open for a jump shot. You got to stay attached. You're lucky he couldn't punish the board.
At the end of one, closely contested game so far. Pacers lead by one. It's the NBA on 2K Sports from the Palace of Auburn Hills. So far, it's been a closely contested game as we get the second quarter up and going. And let's quickly break down the game, guys, we have seen from Indiana. What do you think?
They've done a nice job on the offensive boards here, guys, and I think that was the difference in that first quarter. Really pounding the offensive glass.
Well, they set the tone early with their mindset, their tenacity, and their hustle. I mean, that's the way they come out, and it's served them well.
Number 45, he's guarded by Purdue. Taking it again. And so he draws the foul on the shot, on tip of the line to shoot two. The Pacers shooting their first three-point position.
Well, last year, collectively, I mean, this team shot 74% from the free throw. Pretty low number.
Longley's check in for Purdue. Here's Chicago. They trail by one. And here is Harper. To the inside. It's tipped. Now the Pacers moving it up. Here's Fleming. Smooth as silk on the finger roll.
Oh, nice one-man fast break on that.
It sure was. A stylish finish to cap it off, too.
And around a minute gone here in the second quarter. Harper kicks to Pippen. Shot clock at six. Passes it to Wennington. Harper with a screen on Davis. And Davis pulls it down. Davis has got his third rebound tonight. Number 27, defended by Kerr. Pass to Mitchell. Pushing it up. Here's Harper. Finishes it with a slam.
Textbook example there of how to use defense to create offense.
Yeah, beautiful transition play after the steal all the way to the basket.
Wasted no time going from defense to offense.
Yeah, it feels like they're starting to pick up the intensity as the game itself starts to get a little more tight and close.
So Chicago going with an almost entirely new group. Here's Jackson. And the whistle blows on the backcourt violation. He went over and back. Armstrong's checked in for the Bulls. So it's Chicago now. And here's Jordan outside. No good.
The Bulls often staggered at times, guys. And one reason that was the case last season is they didn't have a big three-point threat. Second lowest in the league last season in three-pointers attempted. They really were a team that tried to score the ball inside.
Number 27. And he drops in the layup on the bus.
Well, after that ragged first quarter offensively, they're finally picking up some ground here in the second.
And you know, Steve, we talk about it all the time. Basketball, especially the NBA game, a game of run. Their offense right now on an uptick.
Armstrong kicks to Harper. It's Jordan on the wing. Left side, Jordan. Six on the shot clock. Second chance shot. And he was fouled in the act of shooting. Chance here now for a three-point play.
Boy, he crashed the boards with purpose right there. Well-deserved second chance points for him.
And guys, what do you think about the offensive approach we've seen so far for the Pacers?
And the points they're getting in the lane will really help them open up the floor.
Well, another factor in their offense so far has been their ability to convert and score off turnovers.
Jackson with it. He's picked up by Jordan. Jackson drives in. A finger roll finish at the bucket.
Jackson!
And the Pacers lead by two. And Clark, you mentioned the Bulls last season without Derrick Rose, not the flashiest offense, and Steve had heard him.
You know, having said that, I mean, that is a team that played relatively slow, even with Derrick Rose. But last year, particularly slow, 27th in the league in fast break points. Look, this is a team that hangs its hat on defensive rebounding. fans love them for it. But to make that next step, they're going to have to improve their offense considerably.
Chicago grabs the miss. Jordan's got 3 rebounds so far in the game. Right side, Jordan. Here's Harper. The shot's good on the assist by Pippen. Harper's got 5 now.
What a great little run he's on here in the quarter.
17 seconds left now here in the second. Jackson against Armstrong. And it's very penetrating. Taken away. It'll count. Got it off in time, but it's no good. And we're through 2 here and a good one. It's Chicago. They're up by 3.
And now, brought to you by Sprint.
And it's been great basketball going on in Detroit. Let's get right to it. Chicago with the lead against Indiana. Nice ball movement offensively, making the extra pass, and it's paying off. And slugging it out so far, the Indiana Pacers. And give them credit defensively, they're boxing out and controlling their defensive backboards. Now we'll send you back to the Palace of Auburn Hills. See you next time.
The Sprint.
You know, in order to win your division, you have to be able to win games against the rest of your conference, and that's exactly what Indiana did last season. Tough team in a tough division, and they gave no ground to other teams in the East.
Here's Jordan. The kick out to Harper. Dishes it to Pippen. Screen by Longley. Back and down is Pippen. Now the feed to Armstrong. Off target from outside. And the Pacers, as you mentioned, Clark, very solid against the other teams in the East as they improve to a 31-20 record against the rest of the conference.
And really, that's because this team is built to handle anything that's thrown at them. It's a big, strong, kind of old-school team. They pound the inside, they rebound, they protect the paint. There aren't a lot of matchups that seem to bother this team.
Bulls making a switch here. First checked in. Chicago shooting their fourth shot at the foul line here.
And no surprise, Kevin. I mean, this is a team that's at the bottom of the league. Last season, they shot about 70% as a team.
And, you know, whenever they get into a stretch where it looked like maybe they would turn it around at the line, they would immediately take a step back.
Davis, and the basket is good. The call goes his way. He could be looking at a 3-point play. So, for the Bulls, he comes in for Longley. And it's Kukoc in for Pippen. Purdue the screen. Jordan the pass to Purdue. And that's out of bounds. Chicago will retain possession. Bushler's checked in for Jordan. Here in this third quarter, just over a minute play. Back to Kukoc. Shot clock at 5. All shooting their 5th and 6th free throws of the game. He misses the free throw. And the second free throw, good.
He did the important part at the line there. The heavy lifting, if you will. Made this a 2-possession game.
Pacers trail by 4. Miller gets to Jackson. Back to Miller. Top of the key. It's good. The assist is coming from Jackson.
Well, offensively, he's just one of those guys that needs a touch of space to get his shot up. That's all. And if he runs his man off a screen or somehow finds an opening, man, that's it. He's going to let that thing go.
And there's something else on his resume that can't be overlooked. Just how many times he's taken over at the end of close games and carried his team to the win.
Bushler. And again, no good by Chicago.
It has not been an ideal start to the second half. They missed 3 of their first 4.
And he was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws now for him. Indiana shooting their 4th and 5th shots at the foul line in the game.
2 shots.
And the first one drops. Oh, making the switch here. That one drops. He ties it up. 2 minutes gone in this third quarter now. It's Pippen on the wing. Scott's there. Feeds it to Kerr. Now the pass to Purdue. He's guarded by Davis. Purdue, the pass to Cooper. Nice fake there to create the shot, but it's no good.
You've got to like what they've been doing down there in the mid-point score.
I too. I love it. Their rebounding has been outstanding. So important in a tight game.
Back and down is Pippen. Buschler. Here's Kerr for three. That's good. Kerr's got himself on the board with three there.
And that's like a layup for him. He's just wide open up there.
Number three, defended by Kerr. Pass to Mitchell. He kicks to Davis. Lays it up and puts it in.
Boy, the D has to show a little more fight on the interior than they did on that field. They've got to battle themselves.
Well, this game has been tough, Clark. I mean, they're getting after it. And I think they're starting to run a little bit low on energy, possibly.
It's Pippen with a drive. There's the dish to Kerr. Purdue is guarded by Davis. Davis against Purdue. Great D that time from Davis. Indiana trailing here. Back to Scott. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Bulls will take it.
Well, they couldn't hook up there on what's really a pretty basic pass.
The Blazers making a switch here. Little under 2.5 minutes off the clock now here in the third. Kerr dishes to Kukoc. He passes it to Pippen. And he hits the jumper to drop. Pippen's got 5 points in the quarter.
His presence is very comforting for this team. He's kind of a fallback option for them anytime they need it.
Number 45. He tries for three. Chicago grabs the miss. Scott. Good.
Well, there's no fear out of him, guys. I mean, going straight to the hoop against a much bigger defender. He's got a lot of heart.
He dishes it to Pippen. Pass to Bush. Kicks to Kirk. Purdue with the ball. Three, Pippen. And no good trying to get that one. 3 quarters of play in a close game here. Bulls lead by one. The fourth quarter of action getting underway. We've had a great one so far with both sides coming to play. And what's your take, guys, on the hustle sticks for Chicago?
You know, block shots, guys, a clear indicator on the stat sheet of their excellent defense. I mean, leaving them no room to get off any shots.
And also the steals. I mean, they've really been harassing the ball today, forcing mistakes, really turning that into their advantage.
To take the lead. Number 45. And there's 2 points.
That makes it 10 of their last 12 points coming from inside the painted area.
Yep, that's something that the defense has to put a stop to. Maybe a defensive adjustment is necessary here.
Armstrong kicks to Pippen. He's looking for Jordan and finds him. Pippen, there's the three. Fast break, here comes Indiana. Mitchell's shot is good. And the Pacers lead by three.
Purely from a size standpoint, that is a mismatch that's going to be hard to overcome defensively.
Outside Pippen. He feeds it to Jordan. Back to Pippen. Some nice ball movement by the Bulls. Jordan, the pass to Pippen. Six to shoot. Jordan with power defended by Mitchell. The shot's good from Jordan. Pacers have gone 2 of 3 from the field to get the fourth quarter started. And the Bulls making a change here. Outside Jackson. We've gone about a minute and a half into the fourth quarter. Davis turns it down.
Davis. We knew what was going to happen with that one when he got his hands on it.
Yeah, you know, if the ball comes to him off the offensive boards, Clark, it's going to go back down hard.
It's amazing how many points he salvages for his team.
Al Horford, good coach, is guarded by Davis. Pass to Jordan, just for the shoot. The Bulls need to get a shot off here. Harper's shot's good. The Pacers have gone 3-5 here in the fourth quarter. Pretty good numbers going out of the break. Kukoc with the steal. Outside Pippen. This is to Jordan. Pippen kicks to Harper. Back to Pippen. And there is the feed to Jordan. Fades back. Another one falls for Chicago.
His shoot has been outstanding. That's really one of the reasons his team is up in this game.
Timeout call for Pacers. They trail by one. 137 left in the game. Here's Jeff in for Chicago. Let's find out what Doris Burke has for us.
Improvement. It's not a surprise to see them out in front with the way they have shot throughout the entire game, as a matter of fact. They've been very efficient offensively.
Feeds to Jordan. And stolen by Miller. Leads him in there. It's stolen by Curry. And here we go. The Bulls. Fast break. And Pippen with the basket. He hits this by Curry.
That's a good shot for him there, but it's kind of puzzling to me that he's not calling for the ball today like he usually does.
He has to do more if they're going to pull ahead. The ball is going to switch here. It is checked in. Third point of action now gone here in the fourth. And the double up Jackson. Here's Davis. Plays again. Number 45. And he can find it. Going to go out with a chance to make it three.
Crucial basket. They needed it.
And a moment here to take a look at some of the hustle stats for the Pacers.
With their rebound, they're giving themselves a lot of second chances, and it's really helping.
Another thing they're doing is really taking advantage of fast break opportunities, scoring some easy baskets.
Kirk gets to join. And fouled hard that time. No good to the line and shoot two.
Just absolute domination in this one for Jordan. 13 points when he's made three shots at the foul line.
Well, that's important. When you get to the foul line, any team, when you can outscore your opponent from the foul line, that's critical. And he's trying to do his part right there. You know, the tension cannot be any higher right now. And he looks like he was shooting free throws at practice. Still, no question. You know, something we're seeing less and less of these days, that little finger work.
This could be a turning point.
Kevin, critical possession here.
Shot clock and game clock separated by less than 6 seconds.
Usually, if he gets to the rim, he's converting it into points. But the defense stood tall there.
Kukoc with the steal.
Boy, a three here would be huge.
Yes. Boy, that was a massive sequence of events there. Absolutely clutch defense to trigger the break.
And we've seen games decided on plays clutch just like that.
Effort yeah. And hustle plays often are big plays for a team.
Yeah, what a time to blow up a play and turn it into a slam at the other end.
So a close game sees Indiana take this one. Clark, it was anybody's game.